Have you ever laughed at a joke you thought was hilarious, only to turn around and find that your friends were completely unamused? Humor may seem like a pretty straightforward thing. You either find something funny or you don't. But there's actually a lot more to it when it comes to humor. From how the mind reads a joke to your brain actually being altered, humor can affect you in some very interesting ways. Everyone has a unique sense of humor, but what exactly determines the words, behaviors, or actions that each individual finds funny? According to psychological researcher Rod Martin, different types of humor can be used for specific purposes, and everyone has their own humor style. He identified four main types of humor. Affiliative, which is used to enhance relationship with others. Self-enhancing, which is used to make yourself feel better in certain situations. Aggressive, which is directed at others and includes sarcasm and teasing. And lastly, self-defeating humor, which is used to make others laugh at the expense of putting yourself down. In the world of comedy, the source of humor, method of delivery, and the context in which it is delivered can bring about many different genres, such as deadpan, slapstick, satire, or witty comedy. So, what determines our sense of humor? As you can guess, the reason everyone has a unique sense of humor is because it is based on our experiences in life. More specifically, the social interactions and events that we were exposed to in our childhood play a huge role in what we find funny as we get older. It is thought that a person's sense of humor correlates pretty strongly with one's creativity, imagination, emotions, intelligence, and perspective. The thing scientists love about humor is that it's very complex and therefore fascinating to study. Not only is comedy fun to work with, but there's usually an instant response in the brain, so researchers can observe it in real time. One of the most interesting things about humor is the way that we humans process it. It's more complex than it appears, since different parts of the brain work to process different comedic stimuli. Let's take jokes for example. Neuroscientists in Dartmouth invited people to watch Seinfeld and The Simpsons while connected to a functional magnetic resonance imaging machine, or fMRI, which detects brain activity through blood flow. As each joke came up, the brain went through two stages, detection and appreciation. Detection involves the left anterior frontal and posterior temporal cortices, which are areas of the brain that act like a library. When you see a slapstick routine or hear a funny line, it flips through your knowledge bank to see if the setup is familiar. Then, if the comedians have done their job right, the brain moves on to appreciation. The chemical dopamine is released and leads you to feel pleasure and enjoyment. In 2017, Professor Irving Biederman and his student Ori Amir at the University of Southern California published a major study about the links between humor and neuroscience. Through their research, they found that brain function can actually be changed through creating humor. The study involved two groups of funny people: professional comedians with improvisational skills and amateurs just trying their hand at comedy. Amir and Biederman hooked the participants up to fMRI machines and then showed them cartoons from The New Yorker. The participants were then asked to suggest two captions, one that was funny and one that was just a regular comment. As mentioned before, they saw that two parts of the brain were activated as the groups came up with their responses. In this case, it was the medial prefrontal cortex, responsible for organization and top-down control, and the temporal lobe, an area responsible for the comprehension of speech and visual cognition. The two areas work in tandem with each other, with the temporal lobe acting like a free thinker, and the prefrontal cortex keeping it in check. However, while amateur subjects relied on their prefrontal cortex, the professionals retrieved their responses from the more freewheeling temporal lobe. As Amir put it, the more experience you have doing comedy, the less you need to engage in the top-down control and the more you rely on your spontaneous associations. These findings were pretty interesting because it shows how brain functions can change with experience. Believe it or not, humor was actually seen negatively by psychologists in the past, as they understood it to be more of a defense mechanism used to demean others, and something that should be avoided. While this can be true in certain scenarios, we now understand that humor has many functions, such as strengthening social relationships, and can even benefit your health. Studies in the field of positive psychology has found that laughter can relax muscles, boost the immune system, lower stress hormones, and even lower the risk of heart disease. So having a great sense of humor can improve your relationships, physical health, and in many cases, reduce stress and anxiety and provide you with a positive outlook on life. So remember to keep your heart light and have a laugh every so often, because it really is the best medicine. Thanks for watching! If you enjoyed this video, let us know by giving it a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel and click that bell icon so you don't miss our newest episodes. See you next time!